want to build weekend, I mean, for the network. After that, we are also giving the opportunity if someone wants to share an idea, topic, or a problem, and what kind of solution they are facing now. So it's like 10 or 14 mentioned something, or
are you?
I think this is a true
I'm ready to. My name is Martin. I work for a Dutch company in a very different domain from data science. It's in the field of justice. So what we do is we study what are the legal problems in data. So we study how many divorces there are, how many neighbors, and so on and so forth. And I do a lot of survey research as well. Recently we have a project actually starting right now in Uganda, and there, for this project, we are going to look at social media and a couple of other sources to extract how people talk about their legal problems, what they do about these problems, in order to enhance our data. So, for me, this is a big pain point, because I deal mostly with statistics, but not with data. I want to share with you, we are going to tap into Twitter, into some blogs, into some administrative data, and also in some very interesting source, community radio. In Uganda, radio is a very popular source of information, like people just buy FM transmitters and start transmitting, and then people in the villages especially start listening, and then get healthcare, educational, legal information. So we are going to listen to these shows, transcribe them, and do some text analytics. So this is one of the projects we are doing. And another project is about looking at the websites of big cities like The Hague, Rotterdam, Amsterdam, Sofia, and find out what people complain about. And then find ways to classify this before a public servant is coming, usually after a very long time. So, Sergey gave me the opportunity to share this with you. I have quite a lot of questions, I don't want to overwhelm you, but one of the many questions is what are the good ways to visualize outcomes from text analytics? Another pain point is what are other possible data sources for such type of problems? So we were talking about companies because procurement is mostly about companies. But I'm interested about people. So if any idea comes, I would be very interested to listen. Also, there are a lot of technical questions. We now store Twitter feeds filtered by some keywords into SQL databases, MySQL. But I hear about stuff like MongoDB, etc., etc. I have no clue about that. So if anyone is interested, wants to see the area, please contact me. And just to add to that, our company is based in The Hague, City of Peace and Justice. And there it's part of something called Humanity Lab. So something like this, scientists, data scientists, people from the justice community in The Hague are coming together and thinking about new ways to deliver justice, including through data. So if you're interested, I will keep you posted on the developments there, and probably there will be some way to cooperate. So thank you very much for giving me the opportunity to share my talk.
I don't know, do you expect any answers?
Yeah, we do.
Because
not right now, but
afterwards. Because if it is, I told you, it's a technical stuff which you are wondering. I mean, for me on Twitter, he's one of the masters, I mean.
The master of Twitter.
Yeah, maybe we can maybe we can discuss it later, I'm not sure.
Sure, yeah.
Okay. Just a second, I'm going to make a quick experiment. Who does have some sort of answer or some sort of comment to the thing? Please raise your hand. Okay? Okay, we have two or three persons over there. So this is the way we do it.
Okay, so anyone else, just
I would like to present something because it's like for less than 2 minutes, and I'm really good at saying things in less than 2 minutes. So Currently, I'm analyzing users in social media. That's my topic, and I'm really interested in analyzing Twitter, because Twitter is free, and specifically emotions of Twitter users. It turns out that it is possible to detect by a single tweet if it represents some sort of emotion besides the sentiment that you probably all know about, which is positive versus negative. It can have some more like structure of the emotion. It can have different aspects. It can have different types of emotion, like sadness, happiness, anger, and a few others. There are currently some scientific competitions that are going on in the area, especially for emotion detection. There is publicly available data, which is really valuable. Some experts actually analyzed some tweets and said which of these tweets are represent sadness and to what degree. So there is a task going on. The deadline for it is in January. And I'm willing to participate and create a system that tries to analyze the available tweets and eventually prevent predict the emotion of the tweet. If anybody is interested in that, I will be happy to discuss it and maybe we can collaborate. And the reason why I'm doing this in the long term is a hypothesis that I have, which is for people with depression or bipolar or anxiety, these sorts of diseases, these people are on Twitter and they are sharing their data, which is actually very dangerous for them. It is also a great source for analysis and prevention. So my idea is that after we analyze the emotions of single tweets, we can try to analyze sequences and eventually reach the point where by a sequence of tweets per user, we can predict if this person suffers from some sort of psychological disease. So if anybody is interested, we can.
Okay, the next experiment is the same thing. Who is interested in speaking about this and about this? Please raise your hand. I'm interested, definitely. Okay, you have auditorium then.
Okay. I think that's all for today. So now is the next day. Next part is just networking. So over there we have some beer, and this is the time where it's a network. So you do what you want. Okay, thank you.